One of the main protective mechanisms would be the NRF2 pathway.
Yeah. So I have a feeling that sulforaphane would be just another interesting phytochemical if at almost the same time we, and I use the term we loosely because I was only very peripherally involved with this, but a number of people at Johns Hopkins and in Japan discovered, and in Japan and England, I should say, but a small number of people discovered this NRF2 pathway and really fleshed out all the details of it. And this happened in parallel to the interest in sulforaphane and broccoli. And it turns out that the NRF2 pathway is an extremely important pathway for upregulating the protective enzymes and protective proteins, including perhaps the heat shock proteins, in cells so that they can protect themselves against various insults. It's an integral part of protection against a variety of chronic diseases. And as I say, Tom Kensler, Paul Talalay, Albana Dunkova-Kostova, all at Hopkins, Masi Yamamoto in Japan, John Hayes in England, excuse me, and I'm certainly leaving out a few people, but small number of people initially put this pathway on the map. And it turns out that the NRF2 pathway controls something between 3% and 5% of our cellular proteins. So it's very important.
Wow, I didn't realize it was that much.
Yeah, and you know, why is it important? It's important because it recognizes molecules like sulforaphane through a system, a biochemical system that I hesitate to explain without props and graphs, and also because I'm not the world's expert on this, certainly, but it recognizes sulforaphane or other similar molecules as they enter cells in the cytoplasm of the cells. Then there is actually a chaperone protein that's in the cytoplasm. It's called KEAP1. That molecule, when it binds to sulforaphane or vice versa, changes in conformation and it releases NRF2, which then migrates to the nucleus and turns on or upregulates the antioxidant response element, which is responsible for the transcription, for initiating transcription of a whole series of protective genes, or genes encoding for a bunch of protective enzymes. So and this happens very quickly, this protective response, and it's quite efficient. So to get back to sulforaphane, sort of sulforaphane was discovered, and then everybody started searching for the mechanism by which it acted. The KEAP1 NRF2 mechanism was discovered, and they sort of both developed a following, if you will, in parallel. And it turns out that sulforaphane is still probably the most potent activator of NRF2 to be found naturally, from the natural world. There have been synthetic activators that are more potent that have been made chemically, but sulforaphane still sort of takes the cake in terms of its protective ability and ability to upregulate protective enzymes.